things went back to the Elder Scrolls Daggerfall. So I'm basically at the foot of Castle Daggerfall right now, and this place looks wicked. But yeah, I've been unable to find like a proper schedule where I can like record my videos given the recent lifestyle change. And well, it's snowy here, so that's one thing that's good. The peasants are roaming around about the castle grounds as they see fit, which is something that I never understood about this game. But yeah, let's go. Today's mission at hand is to basically complete two of the mainline Daggerfall quests, which is basically what I've decided to be completing for my playthroughs of Warrior anyway. And I do believe I've got to first talk to the guard. You're free to petition His Highness at this time. Do not stray from the audience chamber unless he have royal blessing to do so. All these people I took politely to the King and Queen, and above all, cast no spells while within these walls. Do you agree with these terms? Yes. This guy literally gives you like an entire terms and conditions documentation before you get to go in and talk to anybody in this damn place. And yeah, basically they've warned us against going in through these doors, going anywhere beyond this hall, I suppose. But he did say hall, so yeah, there's something about that there, isn't there? Lady Bridgewell. Now, one of the things that I can probably do here is complete the concern for Nulfaga first, which is what USB calls it anyway, and that's Queen Aubk-i, and that's Queen Portrait. Lord Bridgewell, that was Lady Bridgewell down there. And who would you be? No bar, of course, Lord. Nobody of significance, I suppose, but I don't know why this woman has a back turned to me. And we will do mostly. Now, here's the thing, I think the people that I need to talk to are through one of these doors, and I can't exactly access them through, just by talking to these people here. But yeah, let's see, let me just go ahead and save the game here. Because I don't want to come in again and if I die trying to go someplace I'm not supposed to go, I don't exactly want to have to reload the game. So, should I talk to the king or the queen? The queen, perhaps? My husband's poor grandmother, Nulfaga, is rumored to be in very frail health. Ah, concern for Nulfaga. Here we go. Her once brilliant mind almost utterly destroyed. She has locked herself in her castle in the Wrothgarian Mountains and experiments in magical cities with no regard for her own safety. I would know of her condition, but few possess the bravery to face the horrors of her castle and speak with her. My reward for a report on her health is a boots. Okay, it's a pair of boots, I suppose. Will you be my champion in this? Well, very well then. Yes, of course, I will. By Thoric's beard. Who's Thoric? I'm glad to have found a champion. The name of her castle is Shedungent, and it should not take you longer than 150 days to go there. She is insane. Shedungent may be a very dangerous place indeed. Be careful. May Kinrith and Mara protect you. Ah, of course. So we have taken the quest for her. And yeah, we still have one person remaining with whom we need to speak to the quest. But I think Wrothgaria Mountains, Shedungent of Wrothgaria. Basically, Wrothgarian Mountains, I suppose. Now I would like to get out of here. There's actually really cats and dogs here, and I was about to record earlier, but then I thought, let me try and find a suitable time when there is less noise around, and that's practically what I'm doing right now. But yeah, let's head over to the Wrothgarian Mountains, wherever they are. I think, yeah, right here. Got it on the first try. That is like a pretty rare thing to happen to me, but I suppose that's that. Something's odd here though. There's only like the horizontal line, there's a vertical line, there's like the longitude. I only see the latitude here. Anyway, even though it is a glitch, I will take it for what it is. Let's travel with 40 days, and that should leave us with around 40 days to spare, including the 40 days it takes to come back. Oh yeah, let me just go and confirm whether I'm properly equipped or not. Oh yeah, so off screen I actually went and bought like a dagger. This is an orcish dagger, so yeah, it's gonna be sick. Orcish wakizashi. So, and elven gauntlet too, I got that as well. So yeah, let's see how difficult this quest actually is. I mean, there was no text related to this, you know, castle when we first entered in its presence, when we first passed in its glory. And I suppose this is the way in. I mean, castles usually have multiple ways in, but most of those ways in are actually, how do I put this? Like, they all spawn in the same location. They're sham. They all spawn in the same location inside of the place. Okay, this flag looks fancy. Command me, an entry shall be yours. Open? Sesame? Okay. Magically held lock. I'm guessing that we have to talk to Nulfaga. Oh, it's a zombie. Oh, damn. Oh, that's an Atronach? I thought that was a zombie. Huh. Strange. The dungeons in this game can be heinously long. So, yeah, it's a little concerning every time a dungeon pops up in the game. That was a sorcerer with like a warhammer. Yeah, this game to get more skins. Because it's the first time I've ever seen a sorcerer with a warhammer. Any hidden doors anywhere? Does not seem to be the case thus far. One thing I've noticed is that the mainline dungeons are still easy to make sense of, so... Oh yeah, I completely forgot to put on the strut, like the... what do you call it? Oh yeah, it should be here. The bracelet of Orc Strength, even though I doubt I would need it in this dungeon, but you never know. I'm focusing on leveling up my axe right now, hence I took out my axe. So I'm guessing there are no hidden doors here. Better to check. Let's go this way. This unlocked something. That was another sorcerer. And somehow I managed to sneak up behind this person. Would do for me. I think somebody just hit me with an arrow. I still can't see who would hit me, but I think somebody hit me with an arrow. Oh no, that's just the sound of interacting with this weapon. Ectoplasm. I have no idea why. Oh yeah, there's sorcerers. It makes sense that a sorcerer would carry ectoplasm with the, you know, alchemical stuff. That looks like a fancy helm, I'm not gonna lie. And there are two ways up from here. I'm guessing I'm just gonna rest until I'm fully healed. Not that I needed it, but it's always better to rest in this game whenever we get the chance to do so. Oh, Atronach! It's a flame Atronach. At that. A fire Atronach, sorry. Yeah, I forget that these people don't really have treasure. Let me just go and explore the store before I decide to go back there and check whatever there was. Yeah, please come to me. I wonder if she made a spell and adamantium playable. Oh, come on. That's gonna sell for a lot. Yeah, I wonder if she actually made the spell and sort of managed to make a save against it. Because it certainly sounded like that. Okay. That was another battle mage, and I'm assuming that the battle mage did something. The battle mage did something. These are iron greaves, of course, nothing of value there. The helm though, plus one. Not too impressive though. Let me just go ahead and rest here until I'm fully healed. I needed this rest. This rest I needed. Stealth and axe have improved, and I am fortified as per, you know, this message writing. So I'll come back here, but first let me just go and check. Okay, we're going to go in there later. First let me just check this area out. Whatever this place holds for me. Which is nothing apparently. Like I was saying, the dungeons in Daggerfall are massive. Usually this module does not have any hidden doors, but again, you never know. Again, I'm just gonna touch a torch, Nothing of consequence there. That's a bottle of something and a frying pan. It's the first time I've ever seen a skillet in this game. I've never seen a frying pan in this game before. I wonder if this is like the kitchen of the new father. Oh, what is this? So I'm assuming there's some of the other mechanism to like interact with this illuminator. I wonder if it has something to do with the torch that I touched earlier. I can hear a flame nearby. I don't know where this flame is coming from, but yeah, I could hear a flame back there. Shackles. Which don't really do anything. I wonder if I came back down the... I suppose not. Did you run away, sir? And here I thought that you'd run away. Mithril, definitely. I mean, I'm not gonna be using it, but it's gonna sell for a lot, so... 120 gold pieces, and plus one, nothing impressive there. You don't have anything of value at all, so you are what you are. I think I've been here. Wait, is that... Is that like a hidden door or something there? Or maybe this is like a room. Because these people were wall glitching, and I'm just going to save the game here because. No, we have not been here yet. This is the first time we've seen any of this. But all the doors are open, which is sort of strange. Steel boots, chain greaves. Oh yeah, I could totally write on the map, couldn't I? So where did I come in again? I do believe it is slightly late. Apparently not. Double clicking does nothing. Okay. If that be your wish. I mean, I wish they still had that feature for Marina where you could like actually write in maps, but apparently you can't do that anymore since it's Cyberfall and everything. Oh, so this is where... okay, fine. This goes back to the top, that room that we were, you know, let me save this room, so... I'm glad that my top and axe is actually doing a good job of handling these people. I don't know if this is like the right way to go, but where do I want to go is the question. I'm sort of turned around, but I don't see any hidden doors down this path yet. I thought I saw like a misplaced wall piece, but Yeah, you never know. Oh, hi there. Didn't even get a hit in before he died. But it still did take him like 2 hits. He could endure 2 hits, so that's, yeah, I will compliment him for that as a sorcerer. These guys will be frail. This sort of felt like a loose wall battle, but yeah. I do not think this is See, like right here. Okay, somebody opened a door somewhere. But here's what I'm gonna do. I'm just gonna encrypt this and let's H2H this guy. I'm guessing this is like a sorcerer anyway. So let's H2H this guy. Let's see how much damage this guy can deal. Like, how much damage we can deal by hand to hand. I think I'm gonna need like some heals for myself. Yeah, I am. Silent Tide, Silent of Venom Antidote, Potion Soul Falling. Let's see here. Healing. Okay, I'm gonna need to go ahead and equip something. This is a claymore, of course, a two-handed weapon. Broadsword, now I could go for that. Yeah, I'm not gonna use a two-handed weapon, so I could probably equip this. So yeah, that's pretty much a hack there. I don't know where all these people popped out from, but look at that, one hit and they're down. That's just the power of, an Orcish Wakizashi. I mean, it is sort of overcharged, and I've heard that Orcish is practically like the best material. Like, theoretically, there are lots of material grades above this one, but from what I've heard, Orcish material is like the best that you can get performance wise. So, yeah, again, that's just what I've heard. So, like I said, I'm not exactly a pro at this game, so could be otherwise. But from what I've heard, like, it doesn't really get better after Orcish, it just keeps going. Like, the pros don't really justify the extra surcharge, basically, after Orcish weapons. So this way I also get to improve my shot rate, I suppose. Now, despite the fact that I just walked here, let me go in and check whether this room has any hidden doors or anything of that nature. Does not seem to be the case. It does not. Oh, I could probably rest here until I'm fully healed. That would be wise, I would suppose. Let's go here. So I'm guessing the advice that I read was mostly for Daggerfall ability, because it does not seem to work for this game. I do not go there, but yes. Yeah, I've not been here. Oh, hi there. Whoever you are, a sorcerer, it would appear. Multi-boons and nothing else. So this dungeon is actually larger. And I'm wondering if it's like a randomly generated dungeon. This module reminds me of the module from... Oh, hi there! How are you doing? These guys, of course, have the treasure. Yeah, this one reminds me from that guy's place. What's his name? King of Worms? Yeah, King of Worms layout there. I forgot the name of the place as well. Chameleon form. Okay. I'm just gonna keep this with me. And I do believe I've seen this module in another dungeon that I've been to as well. If it is indeed the same module, then this is like a huge dungeon. devil back. And yeah, if this is the dungeon module that I remember it being, then it is quite a large dungeon module. The invisibility trick would actually be better if these guys would move after being invisible instead of just standing in the same place. Dang it, so where did you come from? So this guy is hitting me with beam spells, I think. But yeah, this is a pretty large dungeon from the looks of it, and I just hope I'm not in the wrong game, because, well, this is a new experimental time and I don't really have a lot of time to be playing either. I'm gonna get this over with as soon as possible, but at the same time, I do not exactly want to rush things. Good thing is the enemies are all coming out to attack me on their own, and I'm not having to like go around and basically encounter enemies here and there. Oh no, I did not mean to do that. What is this? I want to know what this is. Elven longbow, 620 points of damage, fine. Elven shortbow, 618 points of damage, fine. I'll just sell the shortbow. And what did I have equipped? Let's go back to the axe and the dart shield. And I don't suppose we can like, interact with any of this. These are all dungeon fixtures. Now, the thing is, apparently these boxes could have been looted. These were supposed to be loot repositories. But they never really made the cut in the final game. Let me just go in and save here. That's where we came from. I heard a door opening, probably the story. Can you please die? Thank you. Like a layer of sorcerers, and I suppose Nulfaga, I suppose, is where she pretty much. She's pretty much at home. If there's so many sorcerers here, is what I would say. Her being a student of magic and everything. And yeah, this is the room that I was thinking would have this secret door here. So look at if this door hasn't opened, I probably would have gone back and explored the rest of the place. But since this room opened, yeah, let's just get this guy open. And backstabbing is improved. Okay. Yeah, I'll go back there, but first I want to explore all of this. And I know this doesn't really lead anywhere, I'm just exploring it for the heck of it. But this is new. So this dungeon module I've seen in one of the earlier dungeons that I went to on a side quest. I think it was Thieves Burrow or something. But again, I don't really recall the name. The hell is it? Nope, it's no good. Yeah, I don't think we need a savior. I just want to check for hidden doors or anything of that nature. No, nothing. So yeah, this part doesn't really lead anywhere. I just wanted to go around and explore it for the sake of completion. And this is pretty much where we came up and crossed over. So yeah, that's that. This is all there is in this area. Nothing more. There are no other ways to go anywhere except for this secret tunnel here, which is supposed to be here. And I had a difficult time finding out about the secret doorway earlier when I played the game. And I do suppose, I don't know where this passage takes me, but I do want to go back the stairs and check where that stairway takes me, I suppose. Because I do feel like I've strayed quite far from where I'm supposed to be going. At least the loot is plenty, so there's that. I failed to secure any weapon better than dwarven material. Let me just go and finish this area as well first. I just wish that it doesn't really take me on a long detour of sorts. Which it sort of feels like it is doing. Oh, is that dungeon module? Thank you. as the deck breath infusing touch in module. I'll come back to you. Yeah, it's like a series of corridors, and I did not expect this place to be this large, and I think this is going to be longer adventure on my behalf. But yeah, we'll get to it. I always say that a start is a start, be it good or bad. Oh, so we're on the other side of it, are we? No, I don't think we are. I think we would have been for... no, we don't. This is all uncharted territory, new territory. So... I think I got a skeleton. Those guys... sound drastically different in this game than they did in the arena. I actually prefer the arena sound of skeletons over the sound of skeletons in this game. The sorcerer just died, and I think I see some levers here. I'll go a bunch of what these levers do. Now, what I would like to do is save the game or interact with any of these, because they can lead you to a death. I mean, carelessly interacting with this stuff. I just hope it's not a code where I have to get it done, like, get it right or pay the price. I would assume this is the objective room, and this is the place where I first I think that is the I see that person. Okay, hold up. I need a potion of healing. Who's firing arrows at me? Show yourself. And I think, yeah, this is where Nulfaga is. That's Nulfaga right there, but who's the bastard that's firing arrows at me? Show yourself. Come on, out with it. Oh no, I would like to interact with this person, yes, thank you. At 12 and Saber. Yeah, I'm just gonna remove it from this corpse, since the corpse table does not need it. And, I don't know how I did it, but somehow I managed to find Nulfaga. Somebody's shooting arrows at me, and I don't know who. I swear, if I find this. Oh, there you are. Cast an invisibility spell now. Yeah, so see, now that is a good implementation of the invisibility magic. Nulfaga, my dear. Let me just go and save. Maybe it was safe. Here would be a good choice, I suppose. Choosing out few. Excuse me. Choosing out few words most horrible, not none them read. Verses dream, which with and other spells like terrible curses heaven. Curse Oblivion, my boy is dead, and let Tamriel tremble until he and I find it peace tonight. Shut up the door to his tomb and my home. And that's what Nulfaga said. So how am I supposed to get out of here again? Like, she didn't give me any command for that. Thing down there? Am I gonna backtrack the entire way? I would rather not do that. Like I said, I could hint somewhere here that lets me know what the code is. I mean, I think that was the father. I would like to talk to you, so. Are we done? Sort of anticlimactic, and just load and try again. So, guess what? I inadvertently did follow the correct pathway to the throne room without even realizing it. So, I thought I was going the wrong way, but apparently I was not. As she rambles on, madness of dialogue has several iterations with the common thread in each line. In each is a line, including the word store and shut up in some manner. These will be the clue for a quicker way through the entrance and exit the throne room for the dungeon entrance. Next is strategic relation track with commanding entity shall be yours. A text prompt will appear, and if you say the phrase shut up, the magic lock door will open, revealing the dungeon exit. I see. Shut up the door. Gotcha. Thank you, Queen Nulfaga. You have been indirectly helpful. Well, I probably wouldn't have figured it out without the help of USB anyway, but yeah, let's shut up be the answer. Which is a strange answer for your eyes suddenly sting at a door. Now it tells me stuff. But yeah, that's a very strange code to gain entry into a door, or rather to make a door open. Shut up, you tell the door, and it opens its trap. It is obedient to it. Indeed. What was I about to do? Oh yes. Let me just move some stuff to the wagon, since I have a lot of stuff to move. This, I do believe, is a short book. Yeah, let's move this to the wagon, and the adamantium, metro, the dwarven goods. And yeah, we should be feeling light already. So let's just go and check my stats. Primary skills. Axe should have gone up. Yes, it has. So blood weapon, axe, and long blade. So okay, fine. Let me just travel back to now that keep us equipped, and travel back to Daggerfall. I know it never said anything about going back to Daggerfall, but yeah, here we are. It's strange that going back took me only 29 days, whereas going to Shedungent took me like 40 days. So yeah, sort of strange if you ask me. Magic items, I'm just gonna go ahead and equip this, because I don't want to break it. And yeah, I suppose that's good. That is quite good. Let me get on my high horse. And let's go talk to this queen of ours. It was a fun it is a stand of all, nothing else. It was a fun little dungeon raid, to be honest. I did not expect to, you know, I was literally meandering through ways I didn't know, and I didn't expect to bump into the actual throne room like that. I thought it would be longer, but it was fun. It was fun nonetheless. So northwestish, not exactly northwest either. So we go, depending on this direction, we will find. Actually, yeah, no need for the savior. Now, this is one of the quests involving, you know, people in Castle Daggerfall. The other mainline quest would be where I have to talk to, I think, a chambermaid or a cook or something in Castle Daggerfall, and yeah, now getting to her would be a little difficult. Look at this place. This has an entire moat around it, and of course it does look every bit as stunning. But come on, man, a moat? That's a little bit of an overkill if you ask me. I think I'm gonna pop it in store once, and I'll probably be cutting this part out. I just want to check if there are any, you know, axe upgrades for me. You'll be surprised. Sometimes, I mean, these minor stores have what you're looking for, and the bigger stores don't. So, yeah. Nothing of interest there. Let me just go and check upstairs. I don't know who you are, and I do not care. Of course, it was just regular run of the mill tides. Parchment. Nothing of value there. Iron battle axe. I mean, this shop is so close to the castle, yet it has like some of the most horrendous goods available. Nothing here, and I would suppose nothing up top either. That usually is the case, that the place doesn't have anything good downstairs. It usually does not have anything upstairs either. But not always the case, but could usually, that's like a good indicator of how things are. Like, it's not just the storefront where the shopkeeper is, which has all the goods. There can be goods even in like this room, for example. This room might have goods as well. And yeah, I mean, in the original game, the original vision of the game, these boxes could have been looted, and they were supposed to have like a massive amount of gold, like an obscene amount of gold. Sad to know that it never made the cut in the game, but I would say that the game is very, very generous with its gold anyway. Except for the housing crisis, my god. Housing in ships? No, you are better off not, hunting for houses anyway. Okay, so I wonder if this gives me a blessing to walk around the castle walls as I see fit. You know, go into the auxiliary areas and speak to other people. Queen Aubk-i, your mama said a few things. I confess, I doubted you I would ever see you again. Your news that Nulfaga is still among the living does my heart much good. Here is your boots. Oh, these are magical boots. Okay, powers unknown. Okay, I'll remove them from your inventory for now, and I will get them examined. Let's see what they have to offer. And thank you so much. That's very generous of you. I'll just go ahead and save the game here. And of course, I don't know who I will have to talk to later, but first, before I... Oh no, sorry. Before I go ahead and continue the storyline further, I just wanna go ahead and finish the B storyline. Like, I wanna know more about Minisera, right? Sorry, not Minisera, his lover, whoever that is. I forgot her name, actually. I wonder what this place is. But yeah, I just wanna go to a mage's guild to get that identified. And location, I would like to know about the mage's guild. Roads? There it goes. Mage's guild. Keep going southwest. Okay, horse, calm down. This is southwest? Yes, this is southwest. So I'm guessing this might be the mage's guild. No, that's the temple of Kind. Probably this. Could also be that blue dot up top. Never know. Sometimes I don't know whether walking is better or riding the horse, because both seem to be... Well, actually, walking does take like far more time. But I don't know whether running, like traditional running, is better or just sticking to a horse. This looks like a mage guild. Tiny, but looks like a mage guild. No, that's the Temple of Kind. We overshot it. Let's go straight north. Let's see what that is. Looks like the fighter's guild. This is strange that you there. I would like to know about the mage's guild. Can't help you there, okay. Can I like, talk to you? Excuse me. I wish I knew, could be anywhere. Don't you fucking live in Daggerfall? You don't know about the Mage's Guild. Southwest, still southwest? You have to go southwest, yes, yet. Like, oh, I suppose past the Mage's Guild, but near the city walls. But yeah, I would assume that running barefoot is faster than the horse slightly, because I can't run the horse. This is like the default speed, this is like maximum speed that the horse can take. But I would I don't know, I mean, I would think that running barefoot would be slightly faster than the horse, but it drains your stamina like anything. Let me go and just quickly and try the store, it seems like a pawn shop. But yeah, like I was saying, like, you have to gauge the quality of these mages' guilds, right? So I'll just go ahead and loiter here for about an hour. So that this shop opens up. Oh, I leveled up. How nice is that? I wonder how I leveled up. But, well, I did. So strength, plus one. Willpower, plus one. Again, agility does nothing in this game. And I'll pull maybe one more point to speed. And what else? I'm still left over with one point and no way to like board it at this point. Should we make it like an even 60? I wonder. My personality and my luck are like average, so. I should just stick to willpower instead. I mean, it would help me with my spell saves. 69 does not sound like too bad a number, to be honest. Yeah, let's go with that. I'm now level 9. I think that makes me. Definitely not the guy that I'm gonna be talking to. Nah. That makes me legible to complete the penultimate quest in this game. So everybody has options where you can buy spells from them. And this guy has options where you can make spells from them. Who are you? You look like you can do worms. Nope. I mean, that guy just looks like trouble, and he is trouble, actually. No, not teleportation. I had a funny feeling this guy was going to teleport us. Like, was about teleportation. I mean, this orb floating around him, because I think the last teleporter that we talked to also had an... like, she was playing with an orb, I think. Oh, hi there. Again, no. I don't know why they just want to make this entire place so labyrinthian, but like these mages skill especially, it's like a labyrinth in and of itself. You're useless. Like, you're literally of no use. I don't know why you're in the mages guild. Yes, you. So I want you to identify this for me. 169 gold pieces, okay. Actually, I wanted some information about him, rather. Steel boots of the sealed door. Oh, I can use the wizard lock spell. Not that I'm gonna ever use the spell, but that's good to know, is what I would say. Let me just back out. I mean, I just wish there was this, instead of like. Wizard door, it was probably like some open spell, like boots of open door or something. That would have been far better. But yeah, that was it for today. Thank you for sticking around until the end. Thank you for watching. Even if you didn't stick around until the end, in which case you wouldn't be able to hear me, thank you. But either way, thank you for tuning in, thank you for watching, thank you for sticking around until the end. The next time we come back to Daggerfall, we will be attempting to complete the quest about, find out more about Lysandus' lover that got banished, and that is exactly how we will get to the root mystery behind Lysandus, because thus far whatever we have been doing have been like side missions, and they do help with the main mission, they're tangentially connected to it. This mission that I did today will be the foundation for, Barenziah's letters. So yeah, but for now I will go ahead and first start tackling Lysandus' lover the next time we come back to Daggerfall. That took me a while to get out, but anyway, until then, take care, farewell, fellow earthlings.